Hello and welcome to the Vector Virtual Session, Testing Smart Devices Locally. My name is Simon and I've been working in the Canoe development at Vector for 8 years. Markus and Urs already showed how a pure software system and a cloud system can be tested with Canoe for software. In this talk, I will introduce the IoT enabler. This hardware can be used in combination with Canoe for software. It can be used to access and test a physical system under test using Wi-Fi or Bluetooth Low Energy. Let me start by giving a short introduction. For smart IoT devices, a wide variety of wireless protocols exists. For example, you can have a LoRaWAN device, you can have a Zigbee device, and all these devices are interconnected using gateways or even the cloud. Testing these devices, however, can be a challenge. Different tools for each protocol are required. For certain protocols, there is no tool available at all, and often in-depth knowledge of a specific protocol is required. The IoT enabler hardware addresses these challenges. Using the IoT enabler hardware, Canoe for software is the Canoe for software testing capabilities are extended for smart devices. Now let us take a closer look at connecting IoT devices. One possibility is to connect using the cloud. Urs already mentioned this in his last talk. However, in certain cases, the cloud is not available because of internet regulations or there's no internet connection available at all. This might be one limitation. Another limitation might be that the actual gateway or bridge is not available. So in these situations, you have no chance to do a test of your IoT device. So for these cases, the IoT enabler comes into play. So the basic idea behind the IoT enabler is to provide an open interface for Canoe for software to connect to wireless and wired smart devices. You can see this in this graphic. Canoe for software is connected to the IoT enabler, and the IoT enabler has a support for different wireless and wired protocols, and you can locally access your system under test using those wired and wireless interfaces. So basically, the IoT enabler is complementary to our connectivity cloud solution. It provides a capability to do a test of a smart device without using the cloud. So let's take a look at the conceptual design of the IoT enabler. So as I already mentioned, the IoT enabler connects to Canoe for software. It is connected using a normal USB connection, and connectivity is actually achieved by adding USB hardware to the IoT enabler. For example, you can attach a Wi-Fi stick, you can attach a Zigbee stick, you can attach a Bluetooth Low Energy stick, and so on. So there is no internet connection required at all. You can directly connect to your system under test using the IoT enabler and Canoe for software. Now let us take a look at the actual hardware design of the IoT enabler. So the IoT enabler has this small metal case, and you have different ports available at the IoT enabler. Most important, you have 4 USB host ports available for connecting your wireless devices. You have 1 Ethernet port available. There's also 1 USB device port which is used to connect the IoT enabler to Canoe for software. And there are also 2 HDMI ports for connecting a display. On the back of the IoT enabler, you can find 1 slot for connecting to the GPIO pins of the IoT enabler, and there is one port for accessing the SD card, for example, if you want to flash a new firmware image to the IoT enabler. Now let's take a look at the schematic design of the IoT enabler. It is, as I mentioned, connected via USB to Canoe for software. On the IoT enabler, we have running one main component. This is the so-called control server. The control server basically is receiving commands from Canoe and is sending back the response to Canoe. The control server basically bridges the non-IP protocols to Canoe. So the control server, for example, has a BLE interface, which actually is using a BLE stick, which is connected to the IoT enabler. It has a Bluetooth service available, and it can also extend it by implementing custom protocols. The IoT and the control server is basically written in Python, so it's very easily to extend. And we also offering a possibility to provide custom protocols. So for example, if you have a proprietary protocol and you want to use the IoT enabler and Canoe for software to test your device, you can do your own implementation on the IoT enabler. Our intention is, of course, not that the customer has to implement all protocols, so there's already a support for a wide range of common protocols available on the IoT enabler. At the moment available, there are Bluetooth, there are Bluetooth Low Energy, OPC UA is supported client-side and server-side, and we also provide a RESTful API also for client and server-side. Currently under discussion, it is a little bit depending on the customer requests. We are talking about support for LoRaWAN. We are talking about SDC support from the medical sector, and we are also talking about supporting FRET and Matter, the upcoming protocol for home automation. So one application example is BLE. So if you want to use BLE, you have to attach a normal BLE dongle to the IoT enabler. And then there is already an API available in Canoe for software, which let you do simple operation like scanning for available devices, discovering the characteristics of a device. And you can also subscribe to characteristics to receive sensor values, and you can write the characteristic and you can also read them. One core feature of the IoT enabler is its open design. The device and the software are open and modifiable. We are also talking about or planning to do a integration with Visual Studio Code. So you can use Visual Studio Code to write your own interfaces on the IoT enabler. You can debug them, and you generally can access the IoT enabler using Visual Studio Code. The actual hardware inside the IoT enabler is based on a Raspberry Pi 4B, so it's a commonly known system. And the operating system, of course, is based on Linux. As I mentioned, the control server is implemented in Python, and all the stuff running on the IoT enabler is licensed under an MIT license. And the basic communication protocol is based on JSON messages, so it's very easily to extend and to understand. So let's take a short look at the integration with Canoe for software. In the next session, I will do an extended demonstration where I explain much of the details. So here's just one slide. Interface of the IoT enabler, the control interface of the IoT enabler is described in VCDL. I think Markus already introduced VCDL. So because we are using VCDL, we can easily access the control server interface from our Capital C# or Python APIs for testing and simulation. It is also integrated with Vitesse Studio, so you can easily create automatic tests using the tools Vitesse Studio provides. And of course, the objects defined in VCDL can also accessed for interactive analysis and stimulation. For example, you can use the graphical panels of Canoe, you can use the trace window, you can use the logging features of Canoe. So basically, the IoT enabler extends the testing capabilities of Canoe for software to smart and wireless devices. So finally, let me give a short summary and outlook. So the IoT enabler is the connectivity hardware for Canoe and Canoe for software to test wireless devices and sensors. So it's attached using a normal USB connection to Canoe and Canoe for software. The software running on the IoT enabler is open and can be modified. And we are also planning to extend the IoT enabler to further protocols upon customer request. And we are also planning to provide an open code repository, for example, on GitHub. And this brings me to the end of the talk, testing smart devices locally. In the next session, I will show a demonstration where a smart device is tested using the IoT enabler and Canoe for software. For now, I look forward to your question and to meet you in the Q&A session. See you there.